je meni daj. Hrvatski. Smo. Poštovani novinari, poštovani medijski.
Respected journalists, respected members of representatives of medicine. First, few technical details regarding conference and translation. The official languages of this conference are Croatian, English, Italian, French, German. And in these languages, you can ask your questions. Translation is in Slovakian, Polish, and Spanish language too. We received guidelines when it comes to the radios, how to use them, for those who will record, how they will record, and also how you will take audio in a certain language later on. Archbishop is going to speak in the French language. Consecutive translation here will be in Croatian language, and simultaneous translation it will be in all other languages. Is that functioning, the translations? Yes. Thank you.
Media.
Dear media representatives, you know that on February 11th, the press office of the Holy See has said that the Holy Father Francis has appointed a special envoy for Medjugorje, his Archbishop Henry Kosel, who is now serving in Warsaw, Prague as the Archbishop. The purpose of his mission is to gain a deeper knowledge about the pastoral situation of this reality, and above all, about the needs of the faithful who are coming there for pilgrimages, and based on those, to suggest possible pastoral initiatives for the future. This mission will be exclusively of pastoral kind. It was suggested that Archbishop Hosier, who will continue to serve as Archbishop in Warsaw, Prague, finishes his mission to the end of the coming summer. Forthcoming summer. That was what came from the Holy See. According to this, Archbishop arrived to Medjugorje as a special envoy. As we received from the Office of Apostolic Nuncio in Bosnia and Herzegovina, Archbishop wished to meet you, respected media workers, and therefore I'm going to pass on the microphone to the Bishop, who will speak to you, and then he will answer some of your questions after his talk.
Mesdames et messieurs, bonjour.
Dame et gospodo, dobar dan.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon.
Donner aussi quelques explications et quelques excuses.
Na samom početku želim dati.
At the very beginning, I would like to give you some explanations and few apologies.
De ma mission était définie par le Saint-Siège. Il s'agit, comme nous venons d'entendre, d'examiner l'état de la pastorale des pèlerins.
The frame of my mission was defined by Vatican. It is about establishing the situation and needs of pilgrims and pastoral workers in Medjugorje.
À Medjugorje, je suis arrivé non sachant la situation sur place, mais sachant en même temps qu'il s'agit d'un endroit de pèlerinage à niveau international.
This is my first coming to Medjugorje. I wasn't aware of the situation here, but I knew that it was a place where international pilgrimages take place.
Pendant très longtemps et reste encore un langage diplomatique.
Služím sa francúzskym jazykom, je to...
I speak French language, as for years that was diplomatic language.
Sans doute attendez de moi de mes impressions, de mes conclusions. La première chose que j'aime souligner, c'est le fait très essentiel que autrefois Medjugorje n'a pas été connu dans le monde.
Od mene vjerojatno očekujete...
What you expect of me are probably my impressions. I can say that sometimes there was a time when Medjugorje was not known in the world.
Perdu entre deux montagnes, Medjugorje, ça signifie.
To je bilo malo
mjesto. It was a little place lost between two hills. That is the meaning of the name Medjugorje.
Medjugorje est connu dans le monde entier.
Sad je Međugorje poznato.
Today Međugorje is known in the whole world.
Proviennent de 80 pays du monde.
And we should know that pilgrims are coming from about 80 countries from all over the world.
De pèlerinage, on peut comparer avec d'autres. Par exemple, si à Međugorje a vient annuellement 2,5 millions de pèlerins.
Što se tiče značenja,
when it comes to the meaning and significance of this place, we can compare it with other places if we say that per year there are about 2.5 million pilgrims who come here.
Mais l'autre existe depuis plus que 150 ans.
In Lourdes, there are 6 million people who come, but Lourdes exists for more than 150 years.
À peine 36 ans.
Medjugorje est staro.
Medjugorje is old, only for about 36 years.
La première évaluation qui est très importante pour le futur développement de cet endroit.
It is a time to make a first pile. First estimate, and it is important for the future growing of this place.
Tant de monde vient ici.
Zašto toliki ljudi?
Why so many people are coming here?
Ce qu'on appelle les apparitions de Medjugorje qui ont eu lieu pour la première fois en 1981.
On one hand side, surely they have heard about the apparitions in Medjugorje that took place for the first time in 1981.
Ceux qui viennent ici découvrent quelque chose d'exceptionnel.
S druge strane,
on the other hand side, those who are coming there, who are coming here, are discovering something extraordinary.
De paix et
d'apaisement. The first thing is the atmosphere. It is the atmosphere of peace and reconciliation.
Apaisement du cœur.
It is atmosphere of inner peace, of peace of the heart.
Spiritualité profonde.
Also, what they discover is a huge space for profound religion, spirituality.
Le sens du sacré.
They rediscover or discover in their lives what it means, something sacred, something holy.
Aussi bien le temps sacré que l'espace sacré.
In Medjugorje, they encounter sacred time and sacred space.
Réservé spécialement à la divinité.
That sacral means specially reserved for something that is divine.
Le culte marial est vrai.
Obično se kaže.
Usually it says that Medjugorje is a place of Marian, where we honor Our Lady, and that is the truth.
On voit que le culte de Medjugorje est essentiellement christocentrique.
But if we look in a deeper way, we will see that that actually is actually completely turned towards Christ, Christ-like worshipping. For instance, since the center is celebration of the Holy Eucharist,
prenošenje Božje riječi,
transmitting of the Word of God, adoration of the Blessed Sacrament,
sacrement c'est une présence réelle de Jésus-Christ dans sa divinité, dans son humanité.
Where one discovers the real presence of Jesus Christ in his divinity and in his mankind character.
La récitation du rosaire qui est finalement une prière méditative sur le mystère de notre foi.
Neki otkrivaju molitve.
Some also discover the prayer of the rosary, that is meditative prayer on the mysteries of our faith.
Suivant le chemin de la croix, ils entrent dans le mystère pascal, ça veut dire de la passion, de la mort et de la résurrection du Christ.
And when they pray the way of the cross, they enter into the paschal mystery, which is the mystery of passion, death and resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Le panorama par un accent le plus fort, à savoir le sacrement du pardon, la confession personnelle et personnalisée.
Ovu panoramu završio bih.
I would like to conclude this with the question of the Holy Confession of the Sacrament of Reconciliation, of the personal and personalized sacrament.
Savjerskog stajališta.
On the religious, from the religious perspective, Medjugorje is a very fertile ground.
610 vocations religieuses et sacerdotales d'origine, d'inspiration de Medjugorje.
During the previous years, we noticed and we counted 610 priesthood vocations that were moved by Medjugorje. The greatest number is from Italy and the United States and Germany.
La crise de vocation, surtout dans le pays d'ancienne chrétienté, pays millénaire souvent comme l'Europe occidentale, on voit que c'est quelque chose de nouveau et parfois bouleversant.
When we are aware of crises of vocations in those old countries where Christianity exists for 1,000 and more years, then we can see that this is something new, this is something that can truly touch us in a profound way.
Parce que c'est une seule possibilité de compter des pèlerins avec évidemment une marge d'erreur. On a distribué 37 millions et communion dans les années passées.
If we look at the distribution of the Holy Communion, because that is the only way to keep the track about the number of pilgrims who are arriving here, then we can say that there were 37 million of Holy Communions that were ministered. So there is a possibility of mistake, but this is the number that was counted from 1986 to today, until today. And we can say that the number of pilgrims is even greater, because it is not that all those who come receive Holy Communion. When it comes to evaluating events in Medjugorje, we should differentiate three approaches, three different areas. The first area is the parish.
Paroissiens qui sont ici, qui habitent ici sur place, et dont le nombre dans les 10 dernières années augmentait d'un mille. C'était 1500, plus ou moins maintenant il y a 2500, peut-être déjà plus, d'habitants qui sont ici installés.
Dakle, prva je župa.
The first is the parish. The parish takes care of people who live here, people who work here, and parish is old already, and what can be noticed is that the number of those who live in the parish was increased for 1,000 to 1,500.
Paroisse qui a son histoire, qui a entre autres dans les années 30 de l'année du siècle passé a monté cette croix au-dessus de Medjugorje, était justement la terre d'accueil de ce phénomène de Medjugorje d'aujourd'hui.
That parish that in the previous century, in the 30s years, built the way of the cross and cross mountain was the parish that accepted this phenomenon of Medjugorje.
S'inscrit aussi la l'histoire particulière personnelle de ce qu'on appelle les voyants.
U priču župe Međugorje se.
When it comes to the story of parish of Medjugorje, what can be wrote was also written is the phenomenon of the visionaries.
Ce sont des pèlerins.
Drugi prostor su.
The second area it belongs to pilgrims.
2,500,000 par an.
As I said, up to 2,500,000 each year who come. And that number is also growing.
Devant les pasteurs qui desservent ce lieu.
Of course, it is a huge challenge for priests who serve here.
L'agrandissement de l'infrastructure actuelle doit justement répondre aux besoins des pèlerins.
And this phenomenon has brought to the increase of the current infrastructure that needs to respond to the needs of the pilgrims.
Espace ouvert ici pour des messes à l'extérieur. Ce sont quelques de ces éléments qui ont été justement ajoutés au fur et à mesure de l'arrivée des pèlerins.
That is this hall, that is the chapel of adoration, and this huge space at the back of the church. All of that was added additionally with the time, according to the needs of the pilgrims who were coming here.
Le développement de la ville.
On the other hand side, we see development of the place.
Des hôtels, des restaurants, de commerce. Ça me rappelle un peu le petit Lourdes déjà.
There are more and more hotels, restaurants, pensions, shops. That reminds me a lot about Lourdes already.
Lourdes, deuxième ville hôtelier en France après Paris.
Probably it is not known that Lourdes is the greatest hotel town in France after Paris. Maybe that is the future of Medjugorje in relation to Sarajevo.
La population augmente et aussi augmente la capacité d'accueil des pèlerins.
Dakle, populacija raste.
So population is growing, and what is also growing is the possibility of accommodating pilgrims.
Troisième espace.
Tu je i treći prostor.
That is, there is a third area too.
Communauté, des associations, des œuvres sociales et caritatives que nous évaluons à une trentaine.
U Međugorju su se nastanile zajednice.
In Medjugorje there are various communities, humanitarian associations and activities, and we think that there are about 30 of them.
De Medjugorje qui ont pris leurs racines ici.
Some come from Medjugorje.
Pays.
Their roots are here.
Se sont installés ici pour vivre cette atmosphère et aussi ce phénomène de Medjugorje.
Ima ih koji postoje drugdje koji.
And there are those who have been founded at the other places, who live here, so they would be able to live the phenomenon of Medjugorje.
Original d'ici, j'aimerais s'il tout mentionner qui a été créé par des pères franciscains. Ça veut dire Domus Marije. Domus Marije anche caritativ.
Postoje stvari koje su.
There are things that have been created here, that have been initiated by Franciscans, and probably are something like Domus Maria, which is like Mother's Village. Yes, it is Mother's Village.
L'idée d'accompagner la vie dans tous ces stades, surtout la vie difficile.
It is worth visiting because it is about watching someone's life in those difficult phases. Those are orphans, young people who have difficulties.
Dependent.
Addicts. Men who are there because of drugs.
Alcohol, etc.
Or because of various conditions like alcohol or something like similar, and also those who are disabled and handicapped.
Qui est intimement lié à la foi chrétienne.
It is expression of active love that is intimately related to the faith as such.
Très important qui s'appelle Domus Pacis. Aussi la création de Père franciscain, une maison de retraite en silence et fermée.
There's also another thing that is very important, which is Domus Pacis, a house for the spiritual exercises in silence.
200 groupes qui sont passés par Domus Pacis et qui comptent plus ou moins plus que 42 000 de participants.
We have more than 1,200 groups that passed in this group, and there were more than 42,000 participants in these years.
Transforme les gens de l'intérieur.
That type of spiritual exercises and seminars transforms people from the inside.
Invention importante. De la pastorale de Medjugorje.
A seminary,
in seminars, it is something else. Another fruit of Medjugorje parish.
Certain types de seminaires se développent une fois par an.
Seminars are held each year. They take place once a year.
Un séminaire ouvert à tous.
Already for 23 years, there is a type of seminars that have been open for to everyone.
Depuis 21 ans, il y a des séminaires ouverts aux prêtres uniquement.
And for 21 years, it is exclusively for priests. It is formation of priests.
Réservé aux couples.
For 17 years, seminars for married couples.
Type de séminaire destiné aux médecins et des professions paramédicales.
And for 4 years, seminars for doctors and for medical professions.
Séminaire pro-vie, pro-life.
Last year, first year, we had pro-life seminar that was organized for the protection of human life.
Un séminaire aux personnes
handicapées.
And there's a seminar for persons with disability.
L'intensité de la vie chrétienne ici à Medjugorje qui fait un certain modèle à poursuivre aussi ailleurs.
All of this is showing the intensity of life here in Medjugorje that could be applied at other places.
Le monde d'aujourd'hui est tel que le pape François a déplacé la problématique des séminaires de la congrégation du clergé vers la congrégation de nouvelles évangélisations.
stvarnost svetišta.
The reality of the shrine in today's world is so important that Holy Father has moved shrines from the congregation for the lay people to the pastoral people to the congregation for evangelization. People receive there those things that they don't have at home. In many old Christian countries, individual confessions do not exist anymore. In many countries, there is no adoration before the Blessed Sacrament. In many countries, there is no way of the cross anymore. There is no rosary anymore.
Pour la dernière fois, on a célébré le chemin de la croix il y a 30 ans.
In Bretagne, in France, they told me that the last time they prayed Way of the Cross was 30 years ago.
Assèchement de l'espace spirituel et du sacré cause évidemment la crise de la foi généralisée.
And such dryness of sacred space obviously leads towards crisis of the faith. Here, people come to the source.
Et le soif du sacré, le soif de Dieu, le soif de la prière qui découvre comme un contact direct avec Dieu, ils sentent, je dirais, la divinité ici, aussi par le soin de la Sainte Vierge Marie.
Ovdje taže svoju žeđ.
Here they distinguish their thirst for holy, thirst for faith, thirst towards God. They discover prayer, and all of this takes place with the help of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
De la Sainte Vierge, la Reine de la Paix.
U Međugorju se naglasak.
In Međugorje, the emphasis is on the title of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Here, the Queen of Peace.
Il y a dans le monde entier des églises sous la vocation de la Reine de la Paix.
Možemo reći da to nije ništa.
We can say that this is not something new because all over the world there are churches consecrated to the Queen of Peace.
Aujourd'hui.
Ali ako gledamo.
But if we look at the world context of today's life.
Pape François appelle la troisième guerre mondiale en morceaux.
Then we can see what Holy Father Francis has called and referred to as the Third World War in pieces, in fragments. It is fragmentary, exists somewhere.
La plus blessante, la plus détruisante et destructrice, ça veut dire de guerre civile.
And the cruelest and the most destructive form of the war are those civil wars.
Balkans, vous avez vécu cette guerre civile il n'y a pas longtemps.
You who live here in Balkans, you lived a form of the civil war recently. I lived genocide in Rwanda.
Puis le pays de la plus ancienne chrétienté.
This what you see today in Syria, the country is destroyed, where there is the oldest Christian presence in the world.
De l'armement chimique.
And today what is being used is also chemical weapons.
Notre paysage aujourd'hui, et combien de conflits politiques dans chaque pays.
And that is the reality today, the landscape today. So many political conflicts in each country.
À mon avis, essentiel.
So, to call, to invoke the Queen of Peace, the Mother of God, is important. It is a specific role of Međugorje that is utterly important.
Vous devrez être, chers amis, des porteurs de la bonne nouvelle.
Dragi prijatelji, vi...
Dear friends, you should be carriers of joyful news.
à Medjugorje, on retrouve la lumière.
And you can say to the whole world that in Medjugorje there is a light. And you can find the light again. Because we need these spots of light in today's world that is going down into darkness.
Je vous souhaite aussi de pouvoir s'inscrire ici au séminaire, je ne sais pas quelle activité, pour découvrir ce que vous ne soupçonnez pas encore.
Also, I would like to recommend you, I would like you to sign up for some seminar here in Medjugorje, so you would discover something that you wouldn't be able to dream about. Thank you. We have about 20 registered questions. Surely we will not be able to respond to all of the questions.
Français.
I think it would be righteous to start with journalists from Poland.
Danuta z Polski, Echo Maryi Królowej Pokoju. I mam pytanie, jeli to mogło, żeby świeczenik z Polski stalno radił, Franiwac świeczenik stalno radił u owoj żupy, żeby nie toliko od vremena do vremena kao gost, toliko żeby był stalno.
Claro. Is it possible to have a Polish priest who would be currently working here with pilgrims in Medjugorje? Not coming from time to time, but being here all the time.
De Franciscain, mais je crois que...
Provincial treba odgovoriti.
Maybe the provincial should answer this question.
Traduit en haut-parleur en croate.
Si, si. Donc la question est au peuple provincial de demander la province ou les provinces polonaises d'envoyer un prêtre président comme il y en a d'autres ici.
Provincial should be probably asking from the province in Poland to be here as a resident all the time. You heard. Second question, Sanja Pehar, Radio Mir. Your Excellency, from the experience of everything that in these days you experience, where do you see Medjugorje in new evangelization that the church emphasizes today so much? Thank you.
Mais je crois que Medjugorje se trouve déjà dans la ligne droite de nouvelle évangélisation.
I think that Medjugorje is already in new evangelization.
Brojke koje sam vam
numbers that I told you prove that.
Dynamique croissante de la présence des pèlerins ici signifie les besoins qui sont aussi en montant, en agrandissement.
And dynamics of the increase of number of pilgrims shows that the needs are also growing.
Hvala lijepa. Po redu ćemo.
Thank you very much. Then Ivica Džuzel, Croatian Radio TV, National TV.
Ja ću najprije zahvaliti po ovim prekrasnim riječima koje je rekao Medjugorje.
I would like to thank about the beautiful for beautiful words that were said about Medjugorje.
Čuje. Znači zahvala u ime hrvatskog naroda na ovim prekrasnim.
Thank you on behalf of Croatian people about beautiful words of Medjugorje. We haven't expressed such obvious support. There were many speculations, but I found on internet information that last week he already spoke to the visionaries, to the people who had close encounter. What was the impression you had with the visionaries?
Avec les voyants est inscrit dans ma mission, mais pas dans un sens très approfondi parce que cela rêve doctrinale présidée par le cardinal Ruini et les voyants sont allés au Vatican pour justement présenter leur histoire, leur conscience, leur expérience, etc.
It is correct that the contact with the visionaries was part of my job description, but it is not a profound contact. They are going to respond to what Commission is doing, and the Commission is part of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith, and it is Cardinal Ruini who is in the charge. They have already given all the statements there.
Tam nie było żadnych nadzwyczajności, normalny kontakt ludzi dorosłych, niektóre już... Voilà. J'ai eu l'impression d'un contact normal avec le voyant que j'ai vu, un contact très direct. Il ne faut pas oublier qu'ils ne sont plus des ragazzi et ragazze, ce ne sont plus des jeunes garçons ou jeunes filles.
I had completely normal contact with them. Let us not forget those are no longer boys and girls. Some of them are already grandmothers.
Pour apprécier leur rôle, qui sont immergés dans la vie normale aussi, dans la vie de la famille, dans la vie professionnelle. Ils doivent pouvoir vivre leurs enfants, leurs enfants. Et ça fait une certaine proximité par rapport aux préoccupations de nous tous.
We should notice that they are immersed in normal, everyday, regular life of the family. They need to work and support their families, and they have the similar lives to many of us.
Cherche comment gagner la vie, etc. Donc, la vie normale, je dirais, et donc, ils ont été, ce qu'ils disent, ils ont été qui ont intériorisé.
Some are maybe sick, some are trying to survive for their lives. It is normal, regular life, even though they say that they had a privilege of apparitions unlike others.
Ce n'est pas mon rôle de prononcer sur la véracité ou non des apparitions. L'Église ne s'est pas encore prononcée.
It is not my role to speak about the whether these apparitions are genuine or not, because the Church hasn't made that statement yet. Ivan Ugrin, Slobodna Dalmacija, Croatia. Archbishop Hose, it is a great privilege to us that you are here with us, that you surprised us from the very beginning. We thought, as a diplomat, that you will be just walking and passing by here, that you will not speak to media, but this is already your third time you speak, and one of the crucial was in the homily when you spoke about confessions as a miracle of Medjugorje. So I would like to ask you, there was a message when a lady came and said here that she has come here to continue the work that she started in Fatima. This year is the 100th anniversary of the apparitions in Fatima, and last year on 13th of October I had the opportunity to be in Fatima. Cardinal Parolin was celebrated Holy Mass. He is State Secretary of the Holy Father, and there were about 200,000-300,000 people. I do not know exactly. I was going around the whole shrine, and I have never seen anyone confessing there. during the time of the Holy Mass. Later on, I found out that the confessionals were close to new basilica, very deep, and there was a priest said that it's very comfortable there, but no one was coming to confess there, and he was there for 1 hour. Can you make a comment of that? Thank you.
Vous pouvez lire l'histoire des apparitions sur les apparitions successives reconnues.
You can read the history of recognized apparitions.
La Salette, par exemple, mi-moitié du 19e siècle.
La Salette, in the half of the 17th century. Odeux de Pâques in Paris, in Paris, Lourdes, Fatima.
Banneux, en Belgique.
It was in Belgium. It was in the year when Hitler received his power. And then Guadalupe. In the South America. It was during the time when Indians from South America were conquered and colonized. In all of these apparitions, there is something a common title. That the Blessed Virgin Mary is inviting to conversion. That life of the sin should be abandoned and no longer lived. There are also challenges of certain time, of every epoch, of every period. At the end, I would like to finish with the apparitions in Quebeco. For 21 years I lived in Rwanda. And I was a member of the medical commission for the apparitions. And these apparitions happened a year after Medjugorje. And the Blessed Virgin Mary has already shown the spectrum of genocide that is to take place, that happened 12 years afterwards.
Un avertissement.
And that was the warning.
Le message était semblable à celui qui est relaté ici à Medjugorje.
The message is similar to the message that was said here in Medjugorje. It is a calling to conversion.
Les apparitions ont été reconnues par l'Église.
Also calling to peace, invitation to peace, and these apparitions have already been recognized in the Church.
Et par le contexte historique et par aussi approchement temporel, n'est-ce pas?
And I would say that according to the historical context and similarity, those are two very similar places, only 1 year difference, Medjugorje and Quebeco.
Sont vrais ou pas, est-ce qu'ils inventent des histoires ou inventent pas. On a écarté un certain nombre de voyants d'ailleurs.
In the beginning, there were doubts whether those visionaries were authentic, whether they are just saying fairy tales, but there were some visionaries who were shut off.
Plus le problème est complexe, plus il exige du temps pour arriver à des conclusions vraiment valable.
And that is why I ask you for patience, because more complex phenomenon is, it takes more time to receive valid conclusions, to gain that, to accomplish that.
Mondadori. Una domanda.
Paolo Brosio, Mediaset, Italian journalist.
Io la ringrazio per quello che lei ha detto, per questo luogo che mi ha ridato la vita.
Archbishop Hosted, I thank you for what you said about this place, the place that restored my life back.
Sulla collina del Podbordo.
When I saw your photograph on the Apparition Hill, beneath the statue of Our Lady,
sono scoppiato a piangere dalla gioia.
I started to cry of joy.
Ho cercato di divulgarlo in tutta Italia e dalle prime sue interviste ho capito cosa pensava di questo luogo benedetto.
It was already obvious in your first interviews how you feel about this blessed place. And my question is,
da indiscrezioni trapelate in Italia si sa che il cardinale Ruini dopo 3 anni e mezzo avrebbe terminato la commissione internazionale d'inchiesta.
There's a story in Italy that after 3.5 years, Cardinal Ruini has finished the work of the commission.
Dei primi anni di queste apparizioni a Međugorje.
And he concluded that it was authentic in the first years and in the first months of the apparitions. What happened here? I'm asking you, what do you think about this conclusion? Have you read a dossier of the file of the International Commission about this?
Komisije za proučavanje Međugorja.
Malheureusement, je n'ai pas lu le matériel de cette commission puisqu'il n'a pas été publié. Peut-être après.
Unfortunately, I did not read those papers.
Moi, je peux parler avec Cardinal Ruini, mais pour l'instant, je ne peux rien dire. Je ne peux rien dire.
I did not read that because it wasn't published, but I can talk to Cardinal Ruini. But for the time being, I'm not able to say anything.
Seulement questionner les personnes qui travaillent ici, qui sont responsables ou non de la situation, mais aussi visiter des lieux de pèlerinage.
My mission was not only to talk to people who work here, but also to go around the places.
Ce chemin non pas facile qui mène à la statue de la Sainte Vierge.
That's why I climbed this pathway that wasn't easy, that leads to the statue of Our Lady.
Par le fait même qu'il y a la statue de la Sainte Vierge.
And already the fact that there is a statue there is worth each one of us climbing that place.
Un polonais, donc je m'adressais à eux quelques paroles sur le culte marial. Mais évidemment, la presse a déjà dit que j'ai conduit un groupe de pèlerins là-bas. Mais ce n'est pas vrai.
There, I found a group of Polish pilgrims and I spoke to them and I told them a few words about how we could honor Our Lady, Mary and honoring of Our Lady and Marian devotion, but media already turned that into the fact that I took a group of pilgrims there, which wasn't the truth. So I'd just like to add that these questions were already published in the press conference of Holy See. In their report in 2014, it was said that Federico Lombardi, the spokesperson at that time, said that the results of the research were given to the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith. That was the last information we received. It was in January 2014. Datko Pavicic Večerni List, Croatia. Newspaper from Croatia. Your Excellency, Archbishop, all the time when you speak about the events in Medjugorje, you speak about the apparitions. You don't speak about the alleged apparitions, so-called apparitions. I would like to ask you a personal question. Do you believe that here we are talking about the apparitions? And what was that you spoke with Master Bishop Ratko Pevic, who refuses to believe and who is denying these apparitions here? Thank you very much.
Je ne suis pas mon jugement, évidemment, parce que je ne sais pas, je ne connais pas tous les détails, je ne connais pas le gigantesque travail fait par Commission Ruini.
I'm trying to sustain from making my judgment. It's not my job, it's the job of the Commission and Cardinal Ruini.
Si je pense des apparitions, c'est par, pour la simple raison qu'on l'utilise ici. Et je le dis en virgulette. En virgulette, on dit, oui.
Guillemets,
en guillemets. Mais lorsqu'on parle, les guillemets ne sont pas visibles.
Ja govorim o ukazanju.
I speak about the apparitions because that is how we say here. When I say that, then that is kind of like with the quotation marks. But when I speak, you cannot see quotation marks.
C'est surtout du pape qui doit se prononcer.
The same as you, I expect final decision of the commission and of course of the Holy Father Francis.
Ivan Pavković, Al Jazeera.
Ivan Pavković, Al Jazeera.
Evo, poštovani oče nadbiskupe, ove neke komentare koje ste iznijeli o Međugorju.
Respected Archbishop, the comments that you said have caused a great number of emotion. Many colleagues are wiping their tears with what you are saying. What I'm interested in is that we're used to hearing various comments about Međugorje, especially from the church. You are special envoy of the Holy Father. What does Holy Father feel about Međugorje, about the fruits, about the apparitions, about everything that you spoke to us here? What is his opinion? Thank you.
It's a very good question, comme on dit. Hein? Mais,
reklo bi se dobro pitanje.
Mais évidemment, je ne sais pas que pense le pape.
Ja ne znam što misli pape.
I do not know what Holy Father thinks. He never told me.
Parce que le pape, évidemment, prend en considération tout le matériel de recherche et de travaux effectués. Mais je crois que dans son jugement, le fait que Međugorje est un endroit tellement important dans la perspective de la nouvelle évangélisation, je crois que ça peut aussi peser de certaines façons sur le jugement final.
Papa,
je ne dis pas jugement dernier, mais final.
Papa,
Holy Father also needs to see which are the conclusions of the commission, but I think that in regards to the weight that Međugorje has in the context of the new evangelization, it is surely going to affect the final judgment, the final word in Escribić Laudato TV, Croatian Catholic TV. Praise be Jesus and Mary. Father Archbishop, I would like to express a great gratitude for the warmth and the openness and sincerity that you are giving, not just to Međugorje, but to all those who are connected to Međugorje. And the question is now on the trace of the statements that you gave before you came here to Međugorje, because it is something that wasn't clear completely. You said that your mission you will have to complete in completely different circumstances and in a different way. I would like to know which are those conditions and which is the way that differs you, your work here from the previous work. And you already said that these Marian apparitions are significantly different than the previous ones, even though you mentioned very many apparitions that could be connected together when it comes to calling to the prayer for the peace, for peace. But what is that here that is specific and that is different? Thank you, and we thank Poland for you.
La spécificité des apparitions qui font un nouveau format, je dirais, inattendu, non connu dans le passé, peut-être dans cette dimension-là.
Surely you notice that here what takes place is something that is in a different dimension than before.
On appelle les apparitions de Međugorje, que ça dure déjà 36 ans.
First, duration of what we refer to as Međugorje apparitions, which is like for 36 years.
Međugorje, c'est comme nous chantons dans la préface, sine fine dicentes.
Međugorje visionaries.
Predslovlju kaže, pomozite mi provinciale, sine fine dicentes.
Même s'il y a évidemment dans la hagiographie de certains saints ce phénomène qu'ils ont eu des apparitions pendant toute leur vie.
Even though we can see in the life biographies of some saints, they had apparitions up to the end of their lives.
Il y en a qui ont compté, je ne sais pas, jusqu'à 47 000 apparition individuelle.
Druga specificnost je broj ukazan.
What is also specific is the number of the apparitions. Some have counted 47,000 individual apparitions.
Des personnels fréquents, ça peut donner à distance de 36 ans peut-être un tel nombre, je ne sais pas.
In regards to that, there are six visionaries who have frequent apparitions. When you count 36 years, perhaps even that number is possible. I don't know.
Tant lié à l'endroit.
Besides that, these are not the apparitions that are connected to the place.
C'est toujours dans la grotte.
In Lourdes, Our Lady was always appearing in the cave.
Chêne qui poussait là-bas.
In Fatima, above a tree. Oak tree. Here, according to what the visionaries are saying, the apparitions go follow the person where the person goes.
En chemin, je ne sais pas, à l'église, etc. Donc ce sont des spécificités et la difficulté d'appréciation actuelle.
This could be at home when they're traveling in the church, and these are all specifics that make the work of final decision more difficult. Soon the pre-program is going to begin at 5 o'clock. There are many questions, but I hope that out of what the Archbishop was saying, you will be able to take maybe the response. There may be 10 questions that Archbishop cannot answer in this moment because of the time. We won't have enough time. We thank you all for coming. We thank Archbishop Huser for these words. We thank him for the effort that he has come among you. Thank you so much.